I think after winning a championship, chilling out is really, really easy. And you have great intentions of chilling out for, you know, perhaps longer than you ultimately end up chilling out. But, you know, when you've won, it's really, really weird, because usually when you win, the season seems to take forever to come around, because you want to get out and you want to get started again. Or when you finish second, you know, it's like it's back on you and you're ready to go again. But last winter was, I don't know, where we've not rode that much at all since then. It feels like the winter's just been forever. You know, we tested back at the end of January or whatever, and now I kind of feel like, blimey, might as well have been October. You know, we need to be out riding. I don't think you ever switch off. It's a funny old drug, motorbike racing. You know, you like to think that you forget about stuff for a while, but then you'll get a call about going to open a shop, and then you'll get a call about making an appearance, and you'll get a call about, you know, going out to sort out some product, and then you get a call from a helmet designer, and then you get a call from somebody. So it never stops, you know. You know, it's one of them things that's in you, and I think that it's the reason that I get so touchy when people say, oh, you know, you've got to such and such an age now, you know, you're 40 now, when are you thinking about hanging up your levers? Don't even go there, do you know what I mean? I love what I do so much that I couldn't possibly contemplate even thinking about what, you know, how to end going racing at the moment, you know? Yesterday I went out just for a couple of hours, and I feel like man flu. You know how bad man flu is. It's terrible, isn't it? But I thought, I've got to go out and just clear myself out a little bit or something. So I wrapped up quite warm and went out and sort of turned to, you know, to ride out of the house, and just straight into like a block headwind and, you know, grey sky and whatever else. And I was just looking around thinking, yeah, this is great. This is just what we need, you know. It's not exactly Spain with, you know, sun on your back and, you know, mountains and sea and whatever else and beautiful scenery. But I spent maybe 5 or 6 years living there. And it's funny in a way, because when you live out there, I desired nothing more than having a house back in England and being back in the UK. But, you know, we'd come over for sort of trips or whatever over to the UK, and, you know, silly things like going to the supermarket and everything being prepared, and like all the nice foods that you couldn't buy in Spain and whatever else were there and available. And you just think, oh, it'd be so nice, and, you know, if we could have a house in both places. But when Zach got to a point where he was going to need to go to school, you know, we had to make a kind of decision and choose between the two. But whilst I at that point desired to have a house here, all the time I live here, I desire to live back in Spain. It's really, really weird. But we got quite a good balance. You know, we spend a lot of time there and we spend a lot of time here. And as long as the kids are doing their schooling, I'm happy. When you're winning races and winning championships, everybody's your friend. When you finish third or fourth, you know, sometimes you come back in your own team and they're all like looking at you like, what's happened? What do you think you're playing at? Do you know what I mean? I'm not stupid enough to think for 1 minute that, you know, you'd be here talking to me now if I was the guy that was finishing 18th in every BSB race, because you wouldn't. All right, we're friends, we get on well and stuff, but Motorcyclenews wouldn't send you here to do this if I wasn't getting results. And I know that, you know, it's not a problem. But the one thing that will always be there for me is my family, which is why sometimes some of the decisions I make and some of the things I do, and, you know, how touchy I get if people try and disturb my holidays and stuff like that, it means the world to me, because the only three people that will be there for me forever are my wife and my two kids. You know what I mean? I think it's really, really important to, you know, to keep on top of training, because, yeah, basically, just take cycling for one thing. It's a flipping cruel sport. You know, you get to a level where you're riding all the time, and, you know, you feel quite strong, and every every incline becomes flat, and you know your rolling speed is really, really good, and you know the amount of effort it takes to maintain that rolling speed decreases, so your speed either gets faster if you want to ride at the same intensity or whatever. You take like 3 weeks off the bike, you go back out, you ride over a speed bump and you think you've gone up a mountain. It's like, it's an absolutely savage sport if you don't spend time doing it. But you know, for me, it's always about the next season, you know. Okay, so we finished the season at quite a good level. We won a championship. What can I do now to be stronger next year? So I never like to completely switch off. This is my 20th season racing, right? So over the course of those 20 years, your body just gets used to what you do. You know, if I went and just sort of sat down behind a desk now every day, it'd destroy me. You know, I couldn't do it. You know, I'd be, I don't know what I'd be doing. I'd be trying to bench press the desk or something whilst I was sat at it, just to do a little bit of something to kind of, you know, keep my body going. But I enjoy training, you know, and ultimately if you enjoy it, like your racing, then it's a no-brainer to keep doing it, isn't it? I haven't actually ridden what I'm going to be racing at round one since the end of January or the first day of February or whatever. Bearing in mind the season starts in the first day of April, so 8 weeks off the bike when everybody else has been out testing and smashing lap records, it's not an ideal situation. You know, in effect, I might be rocking up at Donington now with the least prepared team and you know, set up and riding time that I've probably ever had in BSB, and to be quite frank, probably be the least prepared to get going out of everybody on the grid. And when you've done everything you've done, I've finished first or second for the last 5 or 6 years, you know, you'd expect a little bit more. But at the same time, like I said, the team have been doing their bit, and they can't create parts that are in Australia and Thailand. They can't wave a magic wand and make them appear in the UK to get me out testing. It's really, really difficult, you know, because, you know, we've been riding a really, really massive wave, and, you know, we started with a really, really difficult project last year and got it to a good level. But everybody in racing knows you can't stand still. And as it stands at the moment, I don't have a clear idea of what we've got to, you know, to go to battle with this year. But I'm sure the team have chipped away, and hopefully they will have done a good job, and there'll be some updates throughout the season to, you know, to keep us at a good place. My pace and my rhythm last year at Donington was really, really good. You know, I felt super confident, and yeah, just really, really, really enjoyed riding the bike. My lap times were really good, really consistent, but those kind of lap times and that kind of rhythm comes from, you know, 6 or 7 months worth of racing. You know, that was round 10 of 12 last year. As it stands at the moment, you know, if you said to me, go and do a race run today, I'd have to kind of study the bike just to remember where the clutch lever is. It feels like it's been that long since I rode the thing. But you know, I'm going to get out and I'm going to do the best job I possibly can as soon as I can get out on the bike. And we're going to Donington a little bit green, but what will be will be. I'm ready. I'm a given, you know. I've finished first or second and whatever for the last however many years, and you know, perhaps in some ways I'm the marker, or I'm the thing that everybody aims to, you know, to beat. So there's nothing changed in me. If anything, I'm going to be, on a personal level, I'm going to be stronger this year than I was last year. So yeah, you know, I think sometimes that, for whatever reason, BSB doesn't necessarily get the credit that it's perhaps due. You know, you've got some fast riders in World Superbike, and you know, the two guys that I look up to the most in World Superbike are Johnny Ray and Chaz, and they're both riding really, really fast and on a really, really good level. But you look at World Superbike and it's just like almost like a British Superbike Championship abroad. It's just that when Johnny wins his races, he gets to say he's world champion, and deservedly so. Whereas I get to win my races and might get to be a British champion again. Do you know what I mean? And it's like, I'd give anything. I'd give all 5 titles in British championship titles to have a 1 world championship title, because I always did and still do dream of being world champion. And the day that that dream kind of fades out, then I guess it'll be time to think, do you know what, maybe I've had enough of racing now.